Here we are, Bloodstock 2017. Danny's going to do the clapper. Oh, it was that your James, your Bond girl bit then? Oh. Were you going to lean on that?
I was actually going to.
Oh, beautiful. Well, we bung it down. Grab a mic. Dan, you've just played the main stage with Devilment. Awesome. Absolutely awesome set. Stuff from the new album, Mephisto Waltzes. Stuff from the first album. How was it playing it on a big stage? Because you're used to playing on big stages with Cradle, but with Devilment.
No, 145.
Yeah, no.
I stayed over the guitarist from Cradle of Filth last night, Rich. He lives just down the road in Derby. I'm here all weekend with him. Fortunately, he's driving in every day. I went to the cinema last night. It was great. We're not gay. We're not together, right?
Oh,
just saying that. Just putting that out there. Yeah, brilliant.
You've just been putting it out there.
Can I have the orange one?
Yes. There we go.
Okay, looks more professional, the orange one. So 145. I've never played at 145 in my life.
How was it? Was it strange?
It was strange. I was been here since 9 o'clock in the morning. Hence the parking space.
Ah.
Nobody's noticed the fact that we've actually got our car. I won't mention it now.
Okay.
Just in case.
But you got a good parking spot. Did you get a good sound check?
No, don't get a sound check.
Oh, you just got a line check and that was it, and off you go.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I really enjoyed it though. It's great.
Did it? Playing like that, did it take you back to the sort of early... Well, I was going to say, it can't take you back to the early days because you're on a whacking great stage.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Not a whacking great stage.
No. But close to it. It's Bloodstock straight stage. Yeah, yeah.
No, it's good. It was really good fun. Yeah, yeah. It's not much different. It's just... I just like playing in England and because... I don't know, everybody's in the band was like, England's a bit weird, isn't it? So it's not actually England. English people are pretty cool. I didn't actually play it very often. And I was a bit aware of the last incident where we played here.
Yeah, absolutely.
With the gobstoppers at the side of this big.
And you were headlining them, weren't you?
Yeah. And one of them, we had a guy come up on stage with multiple sclerosis. So we had him on his wheelchair. And one of them literally missed him by about this much. One missed our keyboardist like by about this much. One came over to me and I didn't know what it was. I was going to headbutt it and I went, oh shit. And you watched a video, I literally went, oh fuck. And then one hit our guitarist in the back, which cut the set short. And they thought he had spinal injuries because it's pretty brutal.
Yeah, because they were catapulted over, weren't they?
Well, no, he just threw a cricket ball. But he was taken in an ambulance to hospital and all his stage get up and he went to emergency. I can't help but laugh. He was there in a gurney like that strapped and this kid was like going, ooh, look at that funny man. And everybody went, look at that funny man. He was just sitting there in A&E with like loads of other people in all his stage get up. So something good came of it.
Was that something in your mind when you shot on the stage today? Or?
Well, I think it's everybody's mind because if had it come again, we would have sued them. No, it wasn't a court. I mean, why would that happen again? That was just ridiculous.
It was just one or two arseholes a few years ago.
Where was just one person?
Yeah. And so, how do you think the Devilment tracks went down today?
Well, I think it was good fun. Yeah, I mean, it's great. I mean, playing after Whitechapel, which are legendary, playing before Soil Work, hanging around with all the other bands, Testament.
Are you looking forward to seeing Testament later on?
Well, no, because, well, I am. I'd love to see him, but we're doing... doing a sound signing.
Oh, okay.
Be fine, the signing only lasts about 1 minute anyway, so. So we'll be free to do whatever we want. I'm staying around for Ghost tomorrow. I want to see Possessed.
Right, yeah.
Annihilator.
Yeah, Creator.
Obviously, without doubt.
Yeah. But these are all the bands that we grew up on, aren't they? They're the bands that you and I talk about going to see back in the day, and they're still playing.
And the same bands that we usually play on Matt's radio station.
That's right.
And if you don't know Matt's radio station, it's...
TotalRock.com, but you should do, because you're watching their YouTube channel. Yeah! So, the Cradle album, it's near completion.
Well, it's finished.
Well, I mean, it's being mastered and stuff now, isn't it? Or has it been mastered? It's done.
It's already been leaked.
It's already been leaked. I've heard a couple of songs. I've heard the singles, but I didn't realise it's been leaked.
Yeah, it's been nipped. Loads of stuff's been leaked from Nuclear Blast. It's all been nipped in the bud, though. They're very good at that.
When's the release date?
September the 22nd.
Okay, so not long to go. No. So what's next for Devilment? What's next for Cradle?
We're Devilment are writing some more stuff. We're looking at some festivals next year and something... like a Russian tour or something near Christmas.
Wow.
Cradle are about to hit our massive world tour, although it starts Japan, then we do an British tour, and then the main tour starts mid-January right through till mid-June, literally about a week off. It's going to please everybody, my family. Well, maybe, and that's a euphemism, it might please them, might hate it. So we're very, very busy.
There's a lot going on. I have to ask you, how did you feel about QPR beating Reading last week?
How do I feel?
How did you feel about QPR beating Reading last week?
What do you reckon I felt? I felt like elation beyond belief.
I bet you wouldn't have thought that was going to happen, either.
But the weird thing was, at one point, because we're friends with Jays, one point it was QPR top, then Ipswich, and then Fulham. And then Fulham drew. As I was, and then I can't remember, who cares, someone else, Bolton or something.
But you won't be able to get to see the Mighty Isles much this season
I saw them the week before. My daughter took me and drove me as well all the way to London.
Oh my god,
I know, amazing. All that payback,
that, yeah,
all those years.
See, the trouble is I had that for a bit and then my daughter sold her car. And now I'm driving her around again! And she's 25!
What's wrong with you?
I don't know how this happens, Dan. Right, we're doing something this week at Bloodstock. We're writing a song. You don't have to sing. Every band that we interview comes up with the next lyric, one line. They only hear the lyric before, so we've had Decapitated on it, Soil Work, Blind Guardian.
Hate my coffee decapitated.
Yeah. And your line to follow is, it's not gone. I'm terribly sorry, you just can't get the staff. Your line to follow is, I shall shove it upon thou'st shoe. I'm really sorry, I don't know what you can do with that one.
I will shove it on thou'st
shoe. Upon thou'st shoe was the last line. You can take it where you like from there.
And I hope you pick my virulent poo.
I hope you pick up my virulent poo. There's a lot of poo.
Oh, is there? Okay, then forget that then. I don't need one of them.
Well, change poo to something else.
What was the line before?
Shove it upon thou'st shoe.
I would have been a four, but now I'm a two.
I would have been a four, but now I'm a two. Fantastic. Danny Filth, yeah. Devilment,
poet.
Cradle of Filth.
Poet beyond belief.
Yeah, well, he's a poet, and don't he know it? Brat, 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 brat. Metal Gods 2017 represents.
There. This is for Grenfell.
Oh my god.
But it is, yeah.